The media is not in isolation. I think every institution in Uganda is still growing, and I think we'll get there with time. For example, where we started from as media is not where we are.
Yeah.
Beginning from just watching WBS TV and UBC, and now every pastor almost in Kampala has a TV station. But you can also create your own. You don't need to be employed by media to pass on information. I think that we've moved the state, but that is not, I think, where we want to be. I have seen, for example, media these days trying to, trying to front that at NBS, trying to create audio visuals that are short, on point, but then easily consumable, again, because of the competition that social media has put us up. You can no longer break a story because it's already online. So I think that the media owners and practitioners like myself need to start thinking out of the box. And as I said, audio visuals are one of the ways of trying to create this. Podcasts are still picking up. There's need to, for example, tap into that audience. I don't think we should stop. It's nowhere Rome was built in one day. It's a process.
I also think
that we need to, for example, rethink about the what has been said already, that news in Lugana should be at 7 p.m. and news in English should be at 9 p.m. Why?
Can
we just hold the bulletin there and then as opposed to waiting for 9 p.m. At 9 p.m. can you show me something that I actually have not seen online? Can we reserve, for example, like rich documentaries that have been worked on for months and months? Or can you just have one bullet in a week? So you can just tell me everything that happened? Because social media would bring to me everything.
Actually, that's a very good idea.
Be rigid in terms of like what has been said in the past. Who said that in the news that we should begin with current affairs, go to business, and then end with sports? And that's what actually the newspapers also turned into, that sport is at the back. So I think that if we disrupt the market with like change of certain things, there's opportunity for us to grow. In Kenya, you really have a 24-hour news channel, which we don't have here in Uganda. If you perhaps change the NBS into a 24-hour channel, you'd need another maybe NBS 2 to broadcast content like Uncut. Then you need another NBS 3, maybe Samuka TV to broadcast sports.
Yeah.
You understand? So I think that we need to disrupt the market by, for example, changing what is already existing. I want to be home and anchor news from there. Maybe that's what will attract people to watch. I don't have to come to the studios dressed in suits every day and whatever, reading stuff on TV. Maybe I want to anchor news through a conversation. I want to sit down with the newsmaker. This person has done this and blah blah is involved in the story, and let's have a conversation
I see.
That's how it should be. I think that we're still rigid in terms of like changing the norms, and I think the earlier we realize that, the more.
What is the friction here? Is it that the actual people who are putting the money, who own these things, are scared for their investment? Is it that, you know, you guys are not writing very convincing proposals? Why do you think the friction is? Because these are good ideas.
That's a good thing to ask. I think that the media owners, first of all, look at the age group they are in. But maybe not to be an ageist. I don't want to front ageism that they are old and therefore they cannot think. No, I don't think it's the right thing. But I'm just saying that, for example, our times, the way we consume content is not how those guys consume content. I would find, my uncles who piled a bunch of newspapers and did stuff online. I have an app that gives me daily television and now post and can give me all that in one place. I think that that is part of the reason. But also the other reason is, entirely, this is a capitalistic world. The risk is so high that if you disrupt the market, the risk of losing money is so high. But you would rather leave things the way they are, as opposed
play the game,
to...
There's
no research, for example, in Uganda, that if you start broadcasting news in a certain way, maybe it will be consumed. Now, that risk is already existing and is
true,
big. I've invested... You see how NBS moved from Kamocha to Naguru, such a large place, and the park owns the premises and whatever, and then starts to make money to replace where all this investment came from. And then all of a sudden you want to disrupt the market. I would do anything to protect what is already existing.